Jupiter, the largest planet of our solar system, has fascinated astronomers for centuries, and its four moons have been studied by both ground-based telescopes as well as space-based missions. The orbital machinery of these moons has been understood for centuries. The exact story of how these satellites formed, on the other hand, remains a remarkable mystery. And a new theory, drawing upon analytical calculations and large-scale computer simulations, is helping shed light on their origins. Jupiter was born within a protoplanetary disk that orbited the Sun during the first few million years of its lifetime, and as gas and dust rained down upon the newly born planet, Jupiter became encircled by its own circumplanetary disk of satellite building material. In time, this disk grew more and more dusty thanks to a balance between headwind and updraft attained by icy dust grains, only about a millimeter in size. Eventually, the ring of dust around Jupiter became so massive that it collapsed under its own weight into thousands of satellitesimals, icy asteroid-like objects, about 100 kilometers across. The orbits of these satellitesimals are shown here as orange ellipses. Over thousands of years, satellitesimals coalesce into moons. The mass of the growing satellites is depicted here with a logarithmic bar chart on the right. As the mass of a moon crosses a threshold, it begins to raise spiral wakes in the gaseous nebula and migrates towards Jupiter, leaving behind a mess of satellitesimals to birth the next moon. Here we see the first two moons, Io and Europa, form in about 6,000 years. As sequential satellite formation unfolds, the orbits of satellitesimals grow more and more excited. Eccentric orbits slow down accretion, and it takes longer and longer for additional moons to form. In fact, Ganymede makes its debut almost 30,000 years into the simulation. Close to Jupiter, the converging orbits of the first three moons stabilize, establishing the orbital clockwork of the Laplace resonance, wherein for every four orbits that Io completes around Jupiter, Europa completes two, and Ganymede goes around once, with the system returning to its initial state every 172 hours. Our calculations show that this celebrated orbital architecture must have been built from the inside out over a timescale no shorter than about 10,000 years. Eventually, radiation from the newborn sun evaporates the gas from the Circum-Jovian nebula, leaving behind a disk of icy debris and triggering the formation of Callisto. Because of the gas-free conditions in which Callisto forms, its conglomeration takes much longer than that of the other moons, nearly 9 million years. In particular, it achieves about half of its mass in the first 50,000 years, but then takes more than 8 million years to grow the rest of the way. Jupiter's moons are mysterious and fascinating places that contain water, salts, and maybe even the building blocks of life itself. Understanding the formation of Jupiter's moons helps us illuminate the intricate physical processes at play in the solar system's early evolution and unlock some of the deepest secrets held by the planets.